All right, for more analysis on this and to discuss the rest of the day's top stories, let's bring in now Jenna Clarke, Associate Editor of The Australian. Jenna, great to see you. Look, what is your reaction to these comments from Marcia Langton that formed part of the focus in Question Time today?
Yeah, it's been a pretty interesting day, Shari. Look, I think you have to just say this is probably Professor Marcia Langton's deplorables moment that we saw in the 2016 campaign between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. But we must say, since you have been on air, Channel 9 are now reporting that Professor Langton has spoken out about those comments which you just aired in your editorial, saying she doesn't think that majority of Australians are racist, but she does think that the No campaign is basing a lot of their fact in racist tactics.
Which is exactly what she said in those comments.
Yeah.
Precisely what we've just reported.
Yeah.
Now, Jenna, you're from WA. You know quite a bit about the Bunbury region where Marcia Langton made these remarks. Mm. What's the sentiment towards The Voice at the moment in WA?
Yeah, look, I think it's really hard to really extrapolate The Voice from what we saw with those failed Aboriginal cultural heritage laws that were shoved through the Parliament, WA Parliament in 2021, and then walked back by the new Premier, Roger Cook. And I think there is a lot of dissatisfaction with those, with the way that that was handled. And I think a lot of people are really struggling with to try and delineate where The Voice will start and those type of laws will end, because they've just referred back to an older act now. But it was interesting that Professor Langton was front and centre, really pushing this message quite hard in the Bunbury region. It has, you know, a very diverse population. A lot of Noongar people live in the area around the lower southwest region of WA. So a lot of people would be very interested to see what someone of her calibre has to say. But I did find it very interesting that Don Punch, who was the politician seated next to her, who was the regional development minister and also the relevant minister for that area as well, considering that a lot of the WA MPs are really staying out of the fray when it comes to The Voice, and that was sort of chaired by the outgoing Premier Martin McGowan to stay well out of the campaign because he's no longer in public life. And we really have seen no comment from WA ministers about The Voice since the failed Aboriginal cultural heritage law was overturned in Parliament.
Yeah. Look, also on this topic, the front page of The Australian today carried the report by Rhiannon Down and Jeff Chambers that there are now discounts of up to 80% to many cultural and sporting events for First Nations people. The Australian reports that no proof of eligibility is required to access these discounts. Do you think this revelation is actually unhelpful during The Voice campaign?
Actually, I think it's really interesting to see. I mean, I think if you sort of like scurried around and talked to a lot of those institutions, this has probably been going on for quite some time, and it is a great piece by my colleagues at The Australian, Jeff and Rhiannon there. But I think a lot of Australians would understand, and maybe the Yes campaign should have come out and sort of said, look, if you've got a problem with an Indigenous kid from, say, Western Sydney wanting to go and see The Australian Ballet at the Opera House for a non, you know, for a discounted price, then that's on you. So I think it probably will dent the Yes campaign a lot, because again, it's just this vague nature of, you know, what constitutes in, you know, Aboriginality in this country, and how, you know, how The Voice will work moving forward.
Look, let's turn to Queensland now. State Parliament erupting, complete circus today as Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk was grilled again over speculation about leadership rumblings. This, of course, after she returned from her Italian holiday. Let's have a quick look.
If the Premier can't govern her ministers, how can she govern Queensland?
Yeah. I have been leading this state for over 8 years, Mr. Speaker. Elected 3 times. Let's talk about the leaders of the LNP. Whilst I've been here, Mr. Speaker, we've had Campbell Newman. Then we had Lawrence Springborg. I had to write them down because there's so many. If you want to talk about instability, it's on that side, Mr. Speaker.
Jenna, does it look like Anastasia Palaszczuk's days are finally coming to an end? Do you think she will be the Labor Premier who heads to the election?
Absolutely not, Shari. I think, look, I only speak English and barely at that, but I definitely speak desperate woman very well. And I think she really should have turned around and addressed her own cabinet ministers to say, hey, I've been elected 3 times. I'm doing a great job. Because I think what we saw also, not only in Parliament, but at her press conference yesterday, was an act of sheer desperation when she even pivoted to play the gender card, saying, I deserve to be Premier and leader of this party because as a woman, I've taken things on the chin for so many years. And what an inspiration I am to young women and girls. No, I think it's time for a spill, and I think it's going to happen very, very soon.
Yeah, we'll keep across that issue. And Jenna, just have to correct you. You do not speak desperate woman very well, and you are incredibly articulate. Now, the Labor government's $10 billion housing fund, we know that they did that deal with the Greens yesterday. Mm. Albanese has come under attack for doing a deal with the Greens when he repeatedly said during the election campaign that he wasn't going to. But Greens leader Adam Band has conceded he doesn't know how the new funding will be executed. So, you know, what's happened here with the Greens?
I think, you know, when politicians say, let's stop playing politics, this is exactly what has happened in politics this week. It was interesting that we've had a week of the government under immense pressure around the Qantas and the Qatar issue. And then all of a sudden, they've reached into their back pocket and found an extra $1 billion to keep the Greens happy, thrown it on the table and said, look, let's get some Instagram posts up that this is really great news. And it is great news. I mean, I think anyone that is in the housing market at this point in time needs some type of reprieve. But the issue is that the Greens are now coming out spruiking this as a win just goes to show that they should probably stick to saving koalas' houses as opposed to trying to build ones for humans.
All right, great line as always. Jenna Clarke, thank you so much for your time.